The other thing you do is also you focus on what we call emotional engagement. You try to make sure people come along with you really, really well. Now, that's part of the process of making sure that what you deliver gains momentum. Have you noticed that as we've been going through this session, I keep mixing stories and statements and stories and statements? Have you noticed me doing that? Why do you think I'm doing that?
Engagement.
Ah, I'm playing a trick on you. Absolutely, engaging you. Let me let you on a secret. Does anyone... No, not enough gray hair here. Does anyone here remember 4.5 million years ago? I was there. Okay. 4.5 million years ago, when you went around the offices of Bernardo's, what you found was not people sort of saying, I'm a regional manager. No, they were all called hunter-gatherers. That was what they did for a living. They go out hunting and gathering. Now, if you're a human being and you're a hunter-gatherer, this is called bad business. Do you understand? Do you know why? Because quite simply, human beings don't have any of the defense mechanisms other dogs, other animals have. Dogs have got jaws, cats have got claws. Human beings, none of those things. So if you went for a day of hunter-gathering, there was a good probability you yourself would get eaten by something else. Do you see the problem? So a piece of software was written and stuck in your neck, just about here, to protect you. Do you know what that software does? As you go out hunting and gathering, okay, it checks for change. It goes, is everything the same? Is everything the same? Is everything the same? Relax. You with me? Because is everything... That's what it's doing. And when everything's the same, it relaxes. What about if it says, is everything the same? And then all of a sudden, the ground shakes and the birds fly into the air. Do you know what instantly they did?
Run.
How did they know they should run? The software kicked in. And the software does its thing fantastically. What it basically does is, it says, ugh! Okay? It says something horrible has changed locally to me. And it assumes that change is a threat to your security. And the first thing it does is it switches your logic circuits off. Why is it important to have your logic switched off? You haven't got time to think. Thank you. The people who, when the ground was shaking, they went, oh, I wonder what that is. Is it a brontosaurus, a raptor? I don't know. Should we get together and discuss it? They're all dead. They're extinct. You with me? We here because ancestors ran away. Logic off. Second thing it does is, it then switches all your emotions on. Woomph. Yeah? Usually fear. Pumps you full of drugs, legal ones. And then usually what happens at that point is people run away. Then later, when they get their breath back, do you know what they did at that point? The drug level went down, the emotional level went down, they felt less frightened, and the logic came back on. And then they discuss it. We could have killed it with our pointy sticks. I'm not sure. What about that? You with me? Now, you told me leadership was required because of change. If you take people into changing environments and you surprise them, I want you all to double your sales by tomorrow, etc. What do you think is going to happen? They're going to go into this. You must have gone into a meeting recently where somebody announced something, surprised you with something. These days we're sophisticated. You didn't leap up and run out of the room, did you? You sat there, but your stomach was, ooh, and your palms were all sweaty. Did that happen to you? Yes? Okay. We get the same response. And then when you start to try and speak, what you discover is your logic circuits are off. And that's why in the car driving home, you always say, I wish I'd said. You with me? So what we've got there is effectively a really key thing which stops people moving forward. So if you're going to lead people and you go around surprising them or trying to challenge them, basically they'll go into this mode here and they'll react to you emotionally. If someone's reacting to you emotionally, can you win with a logical argument? No, it doesn't work, does it? Try it at home. Your other half says, you don't love me. Say, yes, I do. I can prove it. I remembered your birthday. Does it work? No. You give them a hug. The only thing which beats emotion is another emotion. Yeah? So you give them a hug. Problem at work, you can't go around hugging people. They'll fire you. And anyway, some people are hairy and smelly. You don't want to hug them. So what happens at work usually is we generally use fear. If we don't change, we'll all disappear. We won't be able to provide good service to our children and all the rest of it. We use fear. Fear is great, but it makes people cunning, not creative. If you want to lead them through it, you have to avoid this. And the way I've been avoiding this, going through this session with you, is basically using a very, very simple technique, which is designed to try and get you engaged. And the technique is called issue data question build. Okay, I say, did you ever have a situation where you went into a meeting and somebody announced something? Yeah. And they announced it and you felt a bit of example. Yeah. And what did you do? You run out of the room. Issue data question build. Using that technique, I can actually get you to come along with you without frightening you. Do you understand? Because I'm engaging the creative part of your brain. The creative part of your brain works because the brain uses up all the energy. So the hunter-gatherers always struggled to be full because the brain was using all the energy. So part of the software in your brain says, if you come up with an idea, try and turn it into food. So if I go issue data and I ask you a question, the moment you start to answer that question, you get engaged in what you're trying to achieve. There's nothing you can do about it. When I ask you your hopes and fears, at that point you got interested in this session, whether you liked it or not. My hopes and fears, no? Now you've told me your hopes and fears, imagine I ignore them. Do you think I'd be in more trouble or less trouble than if I hadn't asked you? You've told me. You expect me to deliver to it. Do you understand? This is a technique which is really key in terms of how to move things forward.